Hi girls, I'm back to read another Welly Wisher story. This one is called Emerson and Princess Peep. And I have a feeling it's about chickens. And you girls might know some of these things because you guys have chickens at your house too. Anyway, I'm here with Amy and Catherine, ready to watch on as we read this story. The back says, Welly Wishers are raising chickens. The girls are thrilled when their hen, Queen Ruby, begins laying eggs. But when the first egg hatches, Queen Ruby doesn't seem to know what to do. So Emerson takes charge. Soon the tiny chick, Princess Peep, is following her everywhere. Caring for a chick is a bigger job than Emerson expected. So it sounds like the egg hatches, and her mommy doesn't quite know what to do, Queen Ruby. So Emerson steps in to help out. So let's find out what they find to be kind of hard about raising chickens, okay? So let me turn around here, get the book into view. Emerson and Princess Peep. And here are the Welly Wisher friends again. The Welly Wishers are a group of fun-loving girls who each have the same big, bright wish to be a good friend. They love to play in a large and leafy backyard garden cared for by Willa's Aunt Miranda. When the Welly Wishers step into their colorful garden boots, known also as the Wellingtons or the Wellies, they are ready for anything. Stomping in mud puddles, putting on a show, and helping friendships grow. Like you, they're learning that being kind, creative, and caring isn't always easy, but it's the best way to make friendships bloom. And here's Willa and Emerson. That's who our story is about today. And Ashlyn, Kendall, and Camille. Okay, and here is a picture of the garden map again. We have Carrot's Hutch up here. There he is. And it looks like his little carrot patch. There's the chicken coop. So this is where the girls are going to be spending time in this story. There's their little playhouse, the pond, the wild area, coming on down towards the veggie garden. Wild area down here, tea table, the garden shed. Looks like some gardening going on here by the greenhouse. Here's the garden theater stage where they put on shows. Here's the garden gate by the flower patch up near Aunt Miranda's house. Okay, so let's read on and find out about the chickens. Chapter 1 is called Who is Coming? The Welly Wishers were building something big. This is the most fun project we've ever done, said Ashlyn. Yes, agreed Willa. We'd better hurry up and finish before Mr. Louie brings her. When do you think she'll arrive? Asked Camille.
Sooner than soon, said Emerson. I hope.
Look, said Kendall, pointing. Here she comes.
Here's your chicken, said Mr. Louie. His farm was next to Aunt Miranda's garden, and when the Welly Wishers played, Mr. Louie held up a crate that had a plucky, clucky red and white hen inside.
Thank you, Mr. Louie, said all the Welly Wishers.
Her name is Queen Ruby, said Mr. Louie.
Because she had a red comb on her head that looks like a crown, said Willa, who loved birds of all kinds, including chickens.
That's right, said Mr. Louie, smiling at Willa.
Welcome, Queen Ruby, said Ashlyn. She curtsied as if the hen were a real queen. We've never had a queen in our garden before.
Queen Ruby tilted her head and blinked her bright black eyes as if to say thank you. I'm glad to be here.
Oh, I love Queen Ruby, gushed Emerson. She's wonderful.
Kendall said, look at Queen Ruby. We built you a chicken coop.
I decorated your feeder with flowers, Your Majesty, said Ashlyn.
I made you a nest, said Willa. I hope you like it.
Did you see the weather vane on top of your coop? Camille asked Queen Ruby.
I made this apron, said Emerson. It has two eggs and a little chick.
She twirled to show her apron to Queen Ruby.
Gently, Mr. Louie placed Queen Ruby on top of her nest. Then he said to the girls, you've thought of everything that Queen Ruby might need, and you've made a real nice home for her. I'm sure as sunshine that she'll be happy here.
Queen Ruby ruffled her feathers, wiggled her bottom, and sat up straight on her nest.
She looked as pleased and proud as a queen on a throne.
Keep a close eye on Queen Ruby, girls, said Mr. Louie. She might lay eggs.
If she does, she has to stay on her nest and keep the eggs warm for 3 weeks. Only then can the eggs hatch, so that you'll have baby chicks, the Welly Wishers shouted.
That's right, nodded Mr. Louie. Peeping, cheeping baby chicks, he handed the girls a book about chickens. If you have any questions, look in this book.
Thank you, Mr. Louie, said the girls.
We'll take good care of Queen Ruby. We promise.
As they waved as he drove away, calling out, thank you. We love Queen Ruby. Thank you for bringing her to us.
The Welly Wishers gathered around the chicken coop to admire Queen Ruby.
Emerson sang a song she made up to the tune of Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star. She danced for Queen Ruby as she sang,
good Queen Ruby, feel at home. Fluff your feathers, wave your comb. Eat your feet and stretch your legs. Soon we hope you'll lay some eggs. Good Queen Ruby, we love you, and we'll love your babies too.
The next day, when the girls went to take care of Queen Ruby, they found
an egg, breathed Camille.
Ooh, sighed all the girls in awe.
Good job, Your Majesty, said Ashlyn to the hen.
Queen Ruby blinked and lifted her beak in a queenly manner.
Don't forget to go back to your nest.
And sit on your egg, Willa said.
Otherwise, it won't hatch.
When the girls came to see Queen Ruby the next day, there was another egg in the nest.
And the next day after that, there was another.
Queen Ruby, you are a superstar, said Kendall. You deserve your crown.
Queen Ruby ruffled her feathers. Pluck, 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 she clucked, as if to say, well, of course.
Remember what Mr. Louis told us, cautioned Willa. You have to take good care of Queen Ruby so that she can take good care of her eggs.
She must keep them warm until they hatch.
We'll give Queen Ruby royal treatment, said Ashlyn.
Willa made sure that Queen Ruby always had straw for her nest.
Ashlyn made sure that Queen Ruby always had water to drink.
And Camille made sure that Queen Ruby always had chicken feed to eat.
And Kendall made sure that Queen Ruby always had a nice, clean coop.
Emerson made sure that Queen Ruby always had entertainment.
She danced a little and sang to the tune of Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star.
Sit, Queen Ruby, be our guest. Keep your eggs warm in your nest.
Help them hatch out pretty quick.
Soon you'll have some baby chicks.
Good Queen Ruby, we love you, and we'll love your babies too.
Chapter 2, Princess Peep.
Mr. Louie said that it takes 3 weeks for eggs to hatch, said Willa.
I like your song, Emerson, said Ashlyn. But when you sing, help them hatch out pretty quick,
Your words are wrong. Three weeks doesn't seem pretty quick to me. It feels like a long time.
Think how long it must feel to poor Queen Ruby, said Camille. She's the one who has to sit on the eggs.
And I bet those eggs are bumpy under her bottom, said Kendall.
It must be like sitting on golf balls.
That's why I sing and dance.
For Queen Ruby, said Emerson, spinning on one toe, so she won't be bored.
Emerson sang her song again, but she changed the words a little.
Stay, Queen Ruby, on your nest, though it does not feel the best. When your eggs hatch up in 3 weeks, we will hear some cheery cheeps. Good Queen Ruby, we love you, and we'll love your babies too.
At last, after 3 weeks, the girls and Aunt Miranda heard a new sound coming from the chicken coop. Peep, peep, peep.
The peeping grew louder when Queen Ruby moved and uncovered one of her eggs.
Oh, sighed Willa, the peeping is coming in from inside the egg. It's going to hatch.
Finally, whispered Ashlyn, as Queen Ruby stood up to fluff her feathers and stretch her legs.
Come on, baby chick, Kendall said to the peeping egg. You can do it.
First, the chick pecked a little hole from inside the eggshell with its beak. Pickety, pickety, pick. Then the chick made the hole bigger. Peckety, peckety, peck. And next, the egg cracked, crack. After that, the egg wobbled, wobbly, wobbly, wobble. And then at last, the chick pushed itself out and said, hello. Peep, peep, peep. Peep, peep, peep. Cheep, cheep, cheep.
The chick is kind of wet and scrawny, isn't it? Said Kendall, staring at the wobbly-headed chick.
Well, it's just born, said Emerson. She knelt down so that she was eye to eye with the chick, and she sang, happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday, baby chicken, happy birthday to you.
Congratulations, Queen Ruby, said Ashlyn. Now you have a little princess chick.
Queen Ruby gave a royal bow. She strutted around the coop looking very pleased with herself.
Peep, peep the baby chick. Peep, peep, peep.
You're a very good peeper, Emerson said to the chick. We'll call you Princess Peep.
Peep, 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 answered Princess Peep.
But the more the little chicks peeped, the less she sounded like a princess. Instead, she sounded like a poor, pitiful baby chick calling out to its mother.
Okay, Queen Ruby, Willa said, it's time to get back on your nest now. You are a mother hen.
Willa looked in the book that Mr. Louie gave to the girls. The book says that Princess Peep needs to be kept warm until her feathers fluff. And your other two eggs need to be kept warm as well so that they can hatch too.
But Queen Ruby seemed to think that her work was done. She showed no interest in getting back on her nest, not even when Kendall patted the nest and called, here, Ruby, 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 come.
Queen Ruby ignored Kendall and strolled out into the sunshine.
Puny Princess Peep shivered unhappily.
Oh, you poor little thing, cried Emerson, putting her nose near the baby chick's beak.
Willa looked in the book again.
It says in this book that a chick has to be kept warm, really warm, about 100 degrees, or it will die, she said.
Oh, no, wailed all the girls. We've got to save her. What can we do?
We'll have to make an incubator for her in the greenhouse, said Aunt Miranda.
What's an incubator? Asked Kendall.
It's a special box that's kept warm by a heat lamp, explained Willa. She held up the book to show the picture of the incubator to the girls.
But what about the other two eggs? Asked Camille.
Queen Ruby is ignoring them. She is not keeping them warm now that she's hatched one egg.
The book says that sometimes hens get distracted. Maybe Queen Ruby
will get back on her nest if we take Princess Peep away, said Willa.
Emerson, you stay here at the chicken coop with Queen Ruby and Princess Peep, and when the incubator is ready, we'll move Princess Peep to the greenhouse. Come on, everybody. We have to hurry.
All right. That's chapter two that we finished. The next chapter, A Yellow Puff of Downy Fluff, is what we'll read next. But I'm going to do it on the next video. So stay tuned and come on back on the next video and we'll finish. Okay?